Because in terms of drift velocity, I can find out the value of current. How can you find out? Assume that you have a cross section of area A. Okay? Electrons are supposed moving like this with drift velocity. Charge is E. Number of free electrons per unit volume is small n. Okay? Can you find out the current due to the motion of charge? Try to find out. Okay, so we need to find out in 1 second how much charge will cross this area. Are you getting it? First find out in delta t time how much charge will cross this area. Now assume that there is an electron which is at a distance of Vd into delta t. How much it will travel in delta t time? It will just be able to touch here. So whatever free electrons are there in this shaded zone, will it cross the zone or not? Will it cross the area?
Yes.
Right? So I just need to find out how much free electrons are there in this zone. That will cross in delta t time. Because electron can travel a distance of Vd into delta t in delta t time. So any electron which is beyond this distance, beyond a distance of Vd delta t, will not be able to cross in delta t time. Are you guys clear?
Yes.
So how many free electrons are there inside this shaded zone?
N
is number of free electrons per unit volume into volume of that is what? Area into Vd into delta t, area into length. And into what? Charge of electron. Right? This is what? Total amount of charge that has flown in delta t time. Any doubt? Okay, let me explain it again. See, there is a situation here. The current is flowing like this. Okay? What is flow of current? The movement of charge. So basically charge is traveling in this direction, suppose, and its velocity is Vd. Okay? So I am trying to find out how much charge will cross this area in delta t time. Okay? If velocity is Vd, in delta t time, how much distance the charge can travel? Vd into delta t. So electron, if it is at a distance of more than Vd delta t, will it be able to cross this area? No. So if electron is here, it will be able to just come up to here. If the electron is at a distance which is less than Vd delta t, then only it will cross the area. Because in delta t time, it travels only Vd into delta t. Okay? So all I have to find out how many electrons are there in this zone. That is the amount of charge that will cross the area in delta t time. So how much is the volume of this zone? A into Vd delta t. Vd delta t is length into area of cross section. That into small n is number of free electrons. Into charge of electron is total charge. Okay. So in 1 second, how much charge will flow? Delta q by delta t. So this is what NEA Vd. Any doubt? Okay, so we have got current in terms of velocity, drift velocity. In fact, we should have done this first and then we should be like, okay, we need Vd. And after that, we should have come, you know, done that. But then, yeah, you understand, right, why we need Vd? So we need a value of Vd in terms of micro factors. So we have that. So let us substitute that here to get the value of current. So current will be equal to NEA, Vd is EE by N into tau. So I get current by area equals to NE square E by M into tau. Okay, or I can write E is equal to M divided by NE square capital E into tau times j Is this correct?
Yeah,
I by A is J. Okay? Are you getting it?
Yes.
Fine?
Yeah.
This is most counterintuitive derivation you will have in your syllabus. But I want you to understand what is going on here. Don't just remember.
E is
there. So that should be J equal to.
What?
So there are two E's in there.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry. This is.
Okay. Now, if you compare this equation and that equation, what you get rho as?
N by N E square tau.
So we have found resistivity in terms of micro factors. Now, does that expression make sense? If mass is more, should resistivity be more or not? Inertia is more, it will move less. Right? If charge is more, should resistivity be more or less? It should be less. More current is there. Right? So that is why it is in denominator. And time between collision. If it is more, resistivity should be less. So that is why it is in denominator. And of course, more number of free electrons are there, more is the current.
But resistivity.
Okay. Any doubt on this? Fine. Do you know what is conductivity?
Yeah.
Conductivity is inverse of resistivity. So if this is rho, sigma, which is conductivity, is 1 by rho. Okay? That will be equal to N E square tau by M. Fine. Any doubt? I'm going to solve now. Should I do it?
Yes.
Okay. So in this question, for the benefit of those who are viewing the video, so we have to estimate drift velocity for the conduction electron. Okay? The cross-section area is this much, current is given, and each copper atom contributes to one conduction electron. Okay? Density of copper is given and atomic mass of copper is given. Fine. Density of copper means what? We know that 1 meter cube will have what mass? 9 to 10 to the power 3 kgs. Okay? Now, if I need to find out drift velocity from current, what is the relation? Current is equal to N E A V D. Do I know E? Yes. Do I know A? Yes. I need to find V D. I know I. Okay? But I don't know N also. Fine. So here I want to find N. And what is small n? Number of free electrons per unit volume. And what I have? Mass per unit volume. So can I find out number of copper atoms per unit volume?
Yes.
So 1 meter cube has this much kg. So 1 meter cube has how many copper atoms? This divided by 63.5 into 10 to the minus 3 into Avogadro number. Because this is the number of mole.
Why?
That is grams. This into 10 is for 23. This is number of copper atoms in 1 meter cube. Okay? Fine. So this many are the copper atoms and this many will be the free electrons also. Are you getting it? So this is your small n. Okay? Now what? You have small n also. Put the value for small n. Charge of electron you know. Area is given. So you get drift velocity as 1.1 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter per second. See how quickly you get it. Okay, so we have studied about resistivity and conductivity. Fine. So now the next topic is understanding about resistance. Fine. Do you know the relation between resistance and resistivity? R is equal to rho L by A. Right? How it comes?
The relation of R with respect to resistance.
What is resistance? R is what? It is the hindrance against the flow of the charge, right? It's the hindrance towards it, right? So if you take a small length and then if you take a larger length, where the hindrance will be more? Larger length, right? So that is the reason why resistance should be proportional to length. Are you getting it? Okay. And one more thing, ultimately what is the resistance? It is a constant proportionality between
V and I,
right? So V is equal to what? I into R. This R is nothing but a constant of proportionality between V and I. So if for the same potential difference, you get more current, R should be lesser. Right? Suppose you apply very high potential difference, but current is less. R should be more. Right? So that is the reason why we call R as resistance. Okay? Now if you increase the area, what will happen? If you keep the length same, but increase the area, what will happen? Will hindrance increase, decrease, or remain same? Hindrance will increase.
Decrease.
Why hindrance decreases?
There will be more space for it.
What?
There will be more space for the charge.
No, but number of charges also increases, na? Proportionately.
Yes.
So when I say hindrance, okay, it should be taken as if bulk movement, right? For example, here there are only four charges, right? These four will travel, and here suppose there are 20. Okay, so the traffic here is more number of free electrons will carry the current for the same potential difference. Are you getting it? So since current increases for the same potential difference, R has to decrease. Fine. So resistance should be inversely proportional to area also. Okay. Fine. So now you take a piece of plastic having same length and area than a piece of copper. Which has more resistance?
Plastic.
A plastic, which is a non-metal. It has like infinite resistance, right? So even though you got a relation between the geometrical parameters and resistance, but the resistance do not only depend on geometry. Although resistance depends on length and area, but it is not that it only depends on length and area. It also depends on
nature.
What is the material? What is the nature of the material? Or properties of material? So R is proportional to L by A, and we are putting the property of material inside the proportionality constant itself, and that is rho. Fine. This rho is resistivity, for which you have just now derived the expression. Okay?